So Intel has a brand new mobile chip coming out soon, and the question you might be asking yourself if you're watching this video is, do I care? What does this mean to me? Who is this for? And well, that's why I'm here, to take you through all of the essentials of Intel's new Lunar Lake CPU, and to see if this may be the next chip to power your next laptop. So let me start here, because it's a bit of a change on how you think about Intel's PCs, especially if you haven't been following all the things about laptops. This chip right here is a big departure from Intel chips that you've probably used. If you haven't dug much into Intel's new Core Ultra chips, you are more than likely used to the world where Intel, you know, just adds a ton of power and cranks the clocks, and then out comes more power. But with the new Core Ultra chips, Intel made a bit of a change. And if you look at the die, this one right here, or the physical design of the Core Ultra chips versus like Intel's Core i5s, i7s, or i9 desktops or mobile chips, you're going to notice a bit of a difference. These things right here, these are called tiles. And the big difference, without getting too technical, is that Intel can do things like turn them off and turn them on. And they added their new Xe or Arc graphics to the CPU as well. So simply put, if they aren't using a part of the chip, they can just turn it off and it becomes more efficient. So you can see drastically higher battery life to go along with the actual performance. Now this is all in laptops. We're gonna talk more about desktops later on. Now Lunar Lake, or this chip right here, is the next evolution of this design from Intel. And they went hardcore on both price and power efficiency. The big thing to really think about when we think about Lunar Lake is that they are trying very hard to make things as small and as power efficient and as cost effective as absolutely possible, while at the same time still managing good performance and being premium. This right here tells us something very important about who they're targeting. And here's the deal. You thought I was just gonna wait until the end of the video to actually tell you, but I'm actually a nice guy. So this is targeting what we call thin and light laptops, or ultrabooks. These are very productivity focused, wanting very long battery life, but still need a lot of power and performance for the tasks they'd like to do. So the vast majority of these people are business users, people who basically do a ton of work. Now hold on. Don't leave this video yet, because there is more to this than meets the eye. This isn't your dad or your mom's old take it to work laptop, because these tiles, these blocks, these islands that I was alluding to earlier really have changed just how versatile and outside of the box a business laptop can really be, and what options you have with these laptops. Things like gaming, content creation, and more are still on the table. So buckle up, get ready, because I'm gonna walk you through why this could be way more exciting than you originally thought when you heard my introduction. I know, business laptops, what's fun? By the way, you know what gets me excited, especially if you are enjoying this video, is you liking and subscribing. So why not do that real quick? Oh, and nudge that notification bell so that you don't miss videos like this. I really would appreciate it. Okay, so let's take this from the top. When you think about a standard laptop or even a desktop, usually a CPU has one job, and that's to run all of the programs on a PC. But Intel has taken a bunch of different things that are usually on things like the motherboard separately. And what they did is they put them directly on the chip itself. It's like those cartoon characters that just like stack a ton of food on a sandwich, and then just somehow they're able to just cram it all in. And that's what they did with basically Lunar Lake, is they were able to cram a bunch of stuff in. So let's take a look at Lunar Lake right here. Now what you see here is the usual stuff. You've got your P cores or performance cores. You've got this new island of low powered efficiency cores, which are exciting, and maybe we're gonna talk about that in a different video. And this is the stuff you sort of expect to see on a CPU, you know, the cores and stuff. On mobile, they also have GPUs, and even on certain desktop CPUs, they also include a GPU, which, let's be honest, you've heard about, but you've dismissed it because who really thinks that integrated graphics are good? They've been practically terrible up until this point. But this one, well, there's a lot to be excited about, because this one also has a GPU, but this one is actually based on Xe2, or Intel's new Arc next-gen graphics card called Battlemage. Now, more on that a little bit later. Now, we're gonna start getting into some newer stuff here, things that you don't normally see on something like a CPU. This is the media engine. Not only does it do AV1 encoding and decoding, which is really good for videos and makes things like Netflix, Twitch, and your YouTube experience better. And if you are a content creator, you know what this is, why this is awesome. But it also adds the brand new VVC decode, AKA H.266, which enables things like adaptive resolution streaming. It's the same thing that makes your like viewing experience on those things I just talked about way better, but in mixed bandwidth situations. So if you're used to seeing stuttering or those squares because your bandwidth got down, this is what fixes it. And there's actually a cool thing called screen content coding, which makes text much easier to read. Now let's look at the display engine. This gives you access to your display ports, your HDMI, as well as this new thing called eDisplayPort 1.5, which, not to get into too much detail, but this literally acts and allows direct control of the screen to control things like adaptive sync. So if you're watching a movie at like 24 frames per second, it'll actually change the refresh rate to allow for a better viewing experience. Now, continuing on our little tour along the way, we come to this thing. It's called the MPU, which is all about AI. Now, I'm gonna talk about AI later, but this is all the rage right now from new PCs, not just from Intel, but also from AMD and Snapdragon. It is the buzzword right now, and this is called the neural processing unit. It's all about running AI tasks locally on your laptop. Now, like I said, there is a bit more on this later, but we need to finish out our tour first. This is where things get interesting. It's this thing called the platform controller. This takes things like Bluetooth, Wi-Fi 7, all of your connectivity, and even some security, and puts them all on the chip. Then finally, and this is actually the biggest change, but do you see these two black triangles right there on the top? That right there is actually DDR5 RAM on the chip, and it's either in 16 gigabytes or 32 gigabytes, depending on the configuration you get, and up to 8,500 gigatransfer. Well, you know what, Robey? Thanks for the tour, but what does this all mean? Well, what this means is that all of that space on the motherboard for things like DIMMs for RAM, for controllers, for antenna, all of that can now be so much smaller or actually be removed altogether. Also, because of how Intel designed these chips, each of these blocks or these islands, these units can even be turned off. Even the actual P cores, the performance cores, which is something that you couldn't do in Meteor Lake, meaning that if they aren't in use, they aren't drawing power. Okay, Robey, so what? So what? Guys, this is what this means. This now means that you can make motherboards that are really small, that you can turn off P cores, and that you still have P cores and E cores that are still very powerful, but also very much more efficient. And you even have an integrated GPU on the chip that can run F1 2024 at 1080p above 60 frames per second with ray tracing on and still have really high battery life in a very small, very thin laptop, and dare I say other devices. Okay, all of this allegedly. While some of the things that we saw in person, like the F1 2024 demo, the wattage requirements being lower in certain tasks like AV1 decoding on YouTube, and finally Wi-Fi 7, and even AI all running on Lunar Lake, there is still a lot we don't know. We are very optimistic. Why? Because what I'm starting to see is a blur of lines between the just productivity focused laptops and multi-purpose laptops kind of starting to fade. What we want and what we're getting is a world where you don't necessarily have to sacrifice thin and light and long battery life for something that you can also do editing, gaming, streaming, or so much more if you really want to. Is that the ultimate goal of these laptops? No. But let's be honest, there is a lot of folks who really wish that the laptop they used for work or business was actually way more versatile. I mean, heck, Apple's MacBook line of laptops is about something powerful and sexy and quiet and thin that you can do a lot on. And that is exactly who Intel's targeting. And here's the deal, if it works the way Intel's promising, I'm all about it. I mean, I love my gaming laptop and I love my YogaBook 9i, but if I could have a world where I can have something that is in between for gaming and for business, I could do stuff like Assassin's Creed, Mirage, or some Helldivers 2 after a meeting or two, and it weighs like 2 pounds. And when I'm done gaming, I can still get 4 or 5 hours of battery life. How is that not the dream? Well, so far, Robey, you actually sound really positive. Do you have any concerns? Well, okay, so I do have some, but really, it really comes down to one, and we're gonna see if it actually comes to fruition. While the RAM on chip is awesome, and all of the other features to reduce footprint for Intel and its partners to make them thin and light and powerful, and all of that stuff is awesome, they come with some limitations on bringing my dream, and I assume your many of your dreams as well. 16 and 32 gigs of RAM is actually a lot. But there are still a lot of creators and productivity-focused people out there who need a lot more than that for large data sets, heavy video editing. And my fear is that we're not gonna see some of my favorite laptops like the MSI Stealth or brand new Origin Eon 16SXs because of this RAM limitation. What that means is that maybe we're gonna have less people making Lunar Lake laptops paired with discrete GPUs like NVIDIA's 40 series that they're gonna allow you to switch between productivity and gaming while still having battery life that isn't infinitesimal, and the laptop doesn't break your back when you're carrying it around. But Intel says there is a silver lining, and that's called Arrow Lake. And it's actually the next processor, and it looks to be targeted at replacing their higher-end mobile and desktop CPUs, things like the 14900HX or the Core i9-14900. And I hope it actually keeps a lot of the efficiency of Lunar Lake and allows for thinner chassis and longer battery life like we actually want. And this takes me to my final point, is that honestly, my last concern is there's just still a lot we don't know. I mean, on paper and with all the non-numeric Apple-like graphs that Intel showed during the presentation, there's definitely something there, and it has a lot of potential. And you know what? There are probably many of you who are watching right now who are for the first time, salivating over your next work laptop, which is really cool when you think about it, that you might dream of a cool or sexy laptop that does more than just crank out Excel or PowerPoint. But wait, Robey, I know you said it was your final point, but what about AI? Isn't it kind of all the rage? I'm sure it was probably the first sentence out of Intel's mouth, and you haven't mentioned it at all in any meaningful way. AI was definitely a focus right here in beautiful Taipei, Taiwan, right here at Intel's ITT. I'm not gonna be able to tell you why AI is cool. Really, AI is gonna be like Wi-Fi or graphics. It's not gonna be like TikTok or some magic app that's gonna suddenly have its like aha moment and it's all just gonna make sense. It's gonna be like a gradual introduction of features and agents that are gonna run things like in Microsoft Office or in your favorite editing tool or your web browser. It's gonna do stuff that's gonna help you with writing a paper in your own voice faster. It's gonna do things like complete an Excel sheet more effectively because it knows what you're trying to do. It's gonna do stuff like allow you to ask questions in games when you're stuck, or like quickly record moments because they're neat. Or it's gonna ensure that your PowerPoint is to your boss's liking because it knows what your boss likes. It will be these quality of life things that you won't notice when it's there, but when it's gone, you're gonna miss it. Right now, it kind of feels like it's all about generating images or helping your kids cheat on their homework or stuff that big businesses do in big clouds, and it's stuff that you don't really understand. But companies like Microsoft with their Copilot are trying to pave the way, and I'm sure there's gonna be a time, much like many of you who use Alexa, where you're like, Alexa announce, and then you miss it because you don't have it. Consider this, gamers, you're actually using AI more regularly, more than you ever have. When you basically think about things like DLSS or XeSS, that's AI making your games better. And if you have a GPU right now that's punching above its weight class using the tools, you would absolutely miss that AI if it wasn't there. But the NPU that's on the Core Ultra is gonna provide access to AI when it's offline with less latency and in many ways more securely. There is a lot more to Lunar Lake than I covered today. But what I wanted to do was I wanted to give you this video that was a guide into how this might be something that might be interesting to you. And at the same time, give you a great idea of who this is actually targeting coming out of it. If you have an aging business laptop or you're looking at a thinner and lighter productivity laptop that has a lot of flexibility, but still has long battery life and can do more than just work, Lunar Lake may just be the laptop you're looking for. Inside, you can't really laptop on this. We, of course, have to do our testing. This is all just based on conjecture and what we've been presented, but as soon as we get our hands on one and they become available, we'll absolutely do our testing. And we're gonna see how far we can come from basically the presentations we got in the halls of ITT to what we actually have in our hands and what this actually means. But I've done a lot of talking. So what do you think? Does this sound like something that's up your alley? Does this actually change some of your thinking on laptop design or considerations around AI? are you actually interested in a Lunar Lake laptop? Let us know all that down in the comments below. Now, while you're down there, why don't you go ahead and slap that subscribe button, whip that like button, and ring that notification bell so that you get a notification each and every time we post a video like this right here on Robeytech. Also, if you have questions, you want to talk about laptops, desktops, whatever, head on over to our Discord server, discord.gg/Robeytech. Absolutely amazing place to have these discussions. And you know what? You might just make a friend. Also, make sure you follow us on all the other social channels, and we look forward to seeing you on the next video.